I don't want another war.
The anti-Muslim Danish cartoons of Prophet Muhammad has hurt Muslims worldwide.
Denmark, you will pay!
Denmark, you will pay!
With your blood, with your blood!
With your blood, with your blood!
La ilaha illallah!
La ilaha illallah!
In the name of peace and disobedience! In the name of free speech!
La ilaha illallah!
The anti-Muslim Danish cartoons of Prophet Muhammad has hurt Muslims worldwide. The anti-Muslim Danish cartoons of Prophet Muhammad has hurt Muslims worldwide.
Who's that bent on you?
Allah!
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 The borders of Denmark, so we can invade their country and take their wives and war booty. Allah! Allah!
The anti-Muslim Danish cartoons of Prophet Muhammad has hurt Muslims worldwide. The anti-Muslim Danish cartoons of Prophet Muhammad has hurt Muslims worldwide. The anti-Muslim Danish cartoons of Prophet Muhammad has hurt Muslims worldwide.
Bomb, bomb Denmark!
Bomb, bomb Denmark!
Bomb, bomb Germany!
Bomb, bomb Germany!
Bomb, bomb France!
Bomb, bomb France!
Bomb, bomb Spain!
Bomb, bomb Spain!
Allahu Akbar!
Allahu Akbar!
Baki!
Allahu Akbar!
Baki!
Allahu Akbar!
Baki!
The anti-Muslim Danish cartoons of Prophet Muhammad has hurt Muslims worldwide. The Danish cartoon storm has also sparked a worldwide debate between free speech and tolerance, causing us to question our own democratic values.
I believe that Professor Thomas from the university has come up with a solution.
Thank you, Mayor.
We bury our heads in sand.
American media outlets who acted responsibly by not publishing the insulting cartoons should be lauded for rejecting bigotry. American media outlets who acted responsibly by not publishing the insulting cartoons should be lauded for rejecting bigotry. American media outlets who acted responsibly by not publishing the insulting cartoons should be lauded for rejecting bigotry. American media outlets who acted responsibly by not publishing the insulting cartoons should be lauded for rejecting bigotry. American media outlets who acted responsibly by not publishing the insulting cartoons should be lauded for rejecting bigotry. Should be lauded for rejecting bigotry. Should be lauded for rejecting bigotry. Should be lauded for rejecting bigotry.
No, wait a minute. That's ridiculous. Look, what we need to do is just the opposite. Freedom of speech is at stake here, don't you all see? If anything, we should all make cartoons of Muhammad and show the terrorists and the extremists that we are all united in the belief that every person has a right to say what they want.
I like the sand idea.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, the sand thing sounds a lot simpler.
Let's do the sand thing.
And that's why, in the interest of informed journalism, I brought all 12 with me today. And if you actually look at all 12 in context, it's absolutely clear that these cartoons were not published by the Jyllands-Posten to deliberately provoke or to denigrate the religion of Islam.
But hasn't the cartoon crisis, on the contrary, radicalized Muslims in the Middle East rather than making them...
Maybe it seems this way, but on the long run, it's not going to be that way. You are helping the Muslim to get used to be criticized. Because I believe Islam, like any other religion, is not above criticism.
Freedom of speech and the press were not established so we could spew hatred and bigotry against an entire racial, ethnic, or religious groups. Freedom of speech and the press were not established so we could spew hatred and bigotry against an entire racial, ethnic, or religious groups. Freedom of speech and the press were not established so we could spew hatred and bigotry against an entire racial, ethnic, or religious groups. Freedom of speech and the press were not established so we could spew hatred and bigotry against an entire racial, ethnic, or religious groups.
As far as the cartoons are concerned, I mean, you can like or dislike the cartoons, and you can believe it was right or wrong to publish them. That's one conversation, you know. The other conversation is about violence and intimidation. And I think the problem is that once violence and intimidation enters the subject, it changes the subject. You know, after that, the question is how do you respond to violence and intimidation? And I think a lot of the people, unfortunately, who claimed to be acting sensitively and out of respect were actually just acting out of fear. You know, and I think that's a very dangerous path, because to give in to intimidation guarantees that there will be more intimidation. It doesn't guarantee that there will be less. There will be more.
And what exactly is this First Amendment, Mr. President?
You know, right to free speech.
Mr. President, when your administration came up with this First Amendment, did it not foresee a problem like this might happen? What do you intend to do about this First Amendment, Mr. President? Forgive me, Mr. President, but this First Amendment sounds like a lot of bureaucratic gibbery-jew.
I also want to speak tonight directly to Muslims throughout the world. We respect your faith. It's practiced freely by many millions of Americans and by millions more in countries that America counts as friends. Its teachings are good and peaceful.
This is a war against people who, in many ways, pervert what Islam stands for. Islam stands for peace and stands for nonviolence.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.
It's an ancient problem, power and art, you know, and I think it's to do with the fact that the great, not even the great, but the true artist is speaking from a completely independent point of view. You know, nobody owns him or her. You know, he's not speaking on behalf of an ideology or in the service of something. He's just offering a vision. He's saying, I think it's like this.